All right, good morning, hockey fans. Let's get it going. Day two of the Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament, the 2022 edition. And we are coming to you live from the Mattamy Athletic Center in beautiful Toronto, Ontario, as we get you set for this open division game between the Ice Owls and the Hiboux. The Ice Owls picking up a win in their opening game yesterday. The Hiboux on the tough side of a loss in their game, but with all the skill on this Hiboux squad, you know they're going to be working for a bounce back win today. Let's get you set here with your starting goaltenders for this game. For the Ice Owls, my goodness, did he ever put on a clinic today. The man in yellow defending the goal to our broadcast right, Joey the Wall Cabral, gets the start for the Ice Owls. And in net to start this game for the Hiboux, Dave Brown. They've got two goalies listed on their roster. I don't see Mario Ross on the bench right now. We'll keep tabs on that. Hopefully Blinky is okay. And with two games for both of these teams today, it may just be a question of the coaching staff opting to save Ross for the afternoon game. And speaking of Rosses, I think we better bring in our color commentator, PA announcer for the Maple Leafs, and someone I'm lucky to call a friend, Mike Ross. Welcome back to the broadcast, buddy.
Thank you, Nico. Great to be back here, bright and early on a Saturday, ready to kick off day two of this tournament. And let's face it, I mean, you mentioned Joey Cabral yesterday. That was just an insane performance. And we saw so many good saves from the four goalies, or five goalies last night, even I think maybe even six. I think yeah, we had both games. We had the goalie switches, right?
Yep, you're right.
But between the saves of the night were Cabral and Weber with pucks going off the crossbar down their backs, and in the case of Cabral, he managed to secure it between his pads. Weber flipped it behind his back with a glove. It was phenomenal. What we get today.
And that's it. We are underway with the opening face-off. It's the Ice Owls in yellow working right to left across your screen, the Hiboux in red. And here goes Jason Uha as he brings the puck into the offensive zone. DeMontis streaking towards the net, but they're unable to deliver the pass cleanly. And the puck works its way around the far boards. A couple of mix-up with numbers on the roster. Good thing I'm able to at least recognize some of these players. As Uha digs it off the half wall here. Centers for Craig Fitzpatrick. Backhander, and that one goes off the outside of the net. DeMontis picks up the loose puck as Demo checks his options, feathers it back to the point. Mark Bentz lets one fly, the Bentzy bounce shot. That time it got blocked on its way through, and the puck rolls out through center ice. Mark Bentz takes control, rips it off the boards in front of his own bench. Both teams will make changes on the fly here with 1 minute gone in the opening period. Anthony Chula, he scored that beautiful OT winner in the National Team Showcase and Celebrity game last night. There he makes the pass to Graham Foxcroft. Feathers one in front. They shoot, they score. What a beauty. Brian Cowie on the spot. A little tic-tac-toe, and the Hiboux take the 1-0 lead.
Well, contrary to what we saw last night, where it took a little while for the Hiboux to get going, tonight, or this morning, not even a minute and a half into this game, and they find themselves in the lead, pushing early. Pretty impressive start.
You know, I was chatting with Brian Cowie down in the hallway by the locker rooms maybe about half an hour ago. And he was telling me, he says, Nico, I am so exhausted. I barely slept. I was up at 4 a.m. I couldn't sleep last night. Whatever he did last night, it's working, because he gets the goal a minute and a half into this game to give the Hiboux the 1-0 lead.
That's a heck of a continental breakfast he had this morning at the hotel, and that's what it was.
Graham Foxcroft brings it in. There's a pass. Oh, what a save by Cabral. He flashes the leather and robs Chula on that break. And now here go the Ice Owls in transition. Heislip controlling it, defended closely. Nice job by Beauregard. As Provin tries to dig it loose, the Hiboux get it to the line, and it's just past Heislip out through center ice.
Now, if you're not French, yes, you may not know that Hiboux is the French word for owls.
That's it.
So it's the Owls versus the Owls here. I love it.
The Owls versus the Ice Owls.
The Ice Owls, that's right.
I guess it's a little bit warmer in Montreal.
A little bit, a little bit.
Of course, one of the original founding programs, the four teams in the open division, paying homage to the first four blind hockey clubs in Canada, the Toronto Ice Owls, the Montreal Hiboux, the Vancouver Eclipse, and the Calgary Seeing Ice Dogs. And that's why these teams using those names at this tournament is. Jason Uha dishes it off. That shot attempt blocked as it was Hugh Leduc letting it fly. Good job by the Hiboux as they clear that one down the ice. Icing indicated, and it just crosses the line, so we get the whistle. 3.5 minutes gone in the first. The Hiboux lead 1-0.
Well, the Ice Owls looking for their legs here this morning. I find that it's a little bit different than what we saw last night. Maybe yesterday was just sort of that energy kicking off the tournament. First game, first time back at the tournament a couple of years. But they don't seem to have that instant chemistry from the start of the game that we saw yesterday.
Well, we'll find out if the Ice Owls can get back on the same page, or if the Hiboux rebound as the way they have been so far early on. And here goes Anthony Chula. He's got Foxcroft heading to the net. Centers Foxcroft just missed on the backhanded tip. It rolled just wide. Good pressure there from the Hiboux. But here goes Jason Uha. Looks like the Ice Owls have switched up the lines a little bit today. Yesterday they had Uha, DeMontis, and Fitzpatrick on a line. It looks like today they've split them up. As Chula chases the puck into the near corner. Overskates it, and that'll give Uha a chance to scoop it up for the Ice Owls in yellow. He wheels out. He's got a clear path to bring the puck up the ice. He needs a teammate in the zone. Finds Leduc with the pass. Hugh Leduc tries to get it back, but what a defensive play. As sprawling out for the block was Dustin Butterfield, the founder of the Central Alberta Bullseye, with a huge defensive stop on that two-on-one. I was chatting with Dustin a little bit earlier this morning as well. We got a nice photo together I told him I love that jersey that the Central Alberta Bullseye have, and he was kind enough to let me put it on for the photo. As Yuha wraps it in, yee-haw, Yuha, we are all tied up at one. Rossi, no stopping Jason Yuha when he gets the puck in the offensive zone.
Nah, he's just so quick. And with a lot of these goaltenders, if their lateral movement's not fast enough, or maybe they play that style where they delay their move from right to left just because of they're maybe anticipating a pass across the crease. But in this case, Yuha takes full advantage, comes around the back of the net, just stuffs it home in the bottom right side of the net.
Yeah, downtown Dave Brown did well to make the first save, but couldn't quite get back to the other post in time. And Yuha wraps it in to tie this game at one. And the Ice Owls now back on the offensive pursuit. Fitzpatrick makes the pass to Mark DeMontis. DeMontis working his way out of the corner, checking his options. Nice work with the puck on his stick, and he flips that one just wide of the far post. As tracking over to the corner is Joe Zylak. He takes it for the Hiboux. Tries to hit Dufour with the pass. It's intercepted and quickly fired back inside the zone where John T will track it back behind his own net. T getting a stick to it as DeMontis supplies the forechecking pressure. Nice passing by the Hiboux. They get it up to Marty Dufour, who plays it ahead. And now streaking onto the puck is Julien Blais. Dufour tries to get it back to Blais, but that's intercepted. And now Heislip leads the odd man rush the other way. Here's a two-on-one break. Off the bench comes a defender. Heislip shot. That one just misses after getting the pass from Demo. Craig Fitzpatrick tries to sweep it in front. Good defensive block by Julien Blais. And on the second effort, he chips it over to Anthony Chula. Chula across the blue line. He's got Blais with him on the left wing. Drops it. Blais shoots. Big pad save. The rebound. Cabral there as well to make the stop on Chula as he got that right pad tight to the post to make the save. Net's a little bit off its pegs. Referee gets it back on before the shot comes in. They jam home, but it's waved off. Cabral the wall with a big save with 12:30 remaining in the first.
So it's starting to even out a little bit. We're getting some end-to-end rushes for both teams. Decent enough defense early on for both teams. So we'll see how this goes. It's certainly certainly a bit of a tighter game than we saw, in, certainly in our second game last night, which was a real blowout, unfortunately, but this one a little bit tighter early on.
Yeah, the Hiboux have rebounded better so far, but now they have to try contain Jason Yuha as he brings the puck in the zone. Nice back checking by Foxcroft to rip it away, and now a foot race where Chula gets to it ahead of the defenseman. Anthony Chula for the Hiboux, checking his options. Nice back check there by Edward Laba to get the stick in. Puck rolls right in on Cabral, but he makes the save. Getting some great comments on the live chat thread. Keep them coming in. We'll give shout-outs as we can, including one to Gary St. Denis. We're missing you here this weekend, Gare, but hope you're doing well back home. And a big shout-out to Timo Yikiharu, cheering on from Helsinki, Finland. He says, have a great hockey day. And no doubt that the Finnish blind hockey community is stoked after watching Pulkkinen and Koko put on a tremendous performance yesterday. Both of those players impressing. Yuha shoots! Yee-haw, Yuha! Back-to-back goals for Jake the Snake. And it's 2-1 for the Ice Owls.
What are you going to say? Right?
That's
all there is to say. So you sit back and you enjoy the show as he picks up exactly where he left off yesterday. And, you know, you talked earlier, Nico, about the fact that the lines had been split up. Maybe trying something a little bit different and getting some different looks. Still kind of early in the tournament. But for Yuha, I mean, it doesn't matter where you put him on the ice. The guy's a skater. The guy's a scorer.
I think any winger that gets to play with him is just salivating at that opportunity. And Amanda Proven doing a great job setting up Jason for that goal. Amanda getting the assist on it. But yeah, phenomenal stuff from the Ice Owls. After giving up the opening goal just a minute and a half into this game, they have really answered back and they're on the attack once again as Nathan Tunis let that shot fly. But a good pad save there by Dave Brown. The Hiboux take control of the puck as Zylak plays it ahead. 2-4 across center ice. Defender crashing down there. was Paul Schmold just got enough of Dufour to impede his progress, but now is Julien Blais digging it out of the far corner. He's got Zylak with him there, battling for the puck, but stepping in to make the defensive play is Hugh Leduc. Hislip controls the rolling puck, and now he's got room to skate it out. 9:38 remaining in the first period. Puck chopped loose. Paul Schmold from Edmonton backhands it deep into the zone. Johnny Chocolate Milk Tea. Yes, he loves his chocolate milk pregame, and he loves to block shots. Here he's making a defensive stance in the corner as the Hiboux come up with possession. Chula tried to escape the zone, but good job to hold it in by the ice house. DeMontis shoots. That one just goes wide. Juha picks up the loose puck, trying to work his way out of the corner off the half wall. He plays it below the net to DeMontis. Shielding it there from the check of Foxcroft. Oh, great effort by DeMontis. Tries again the almost Doug Gilmore-like wrap where he went from one side to the other. But two good saves by downtown Dave Brown. Loose puck chipped up the boards but not out of the zone. Held in at the point as that shot coming off the stick of Mark Bentz was blocked. Scrum for the puck in the crease. The Hiboux able to clear it to the faceoff dot. As it's at the point, Bentz with a good play to hold the zone. Better effort from Chula. He muscles it across the line. And now Juha tracks back to get the loose puck inside his own blue line. Juha, bank pass ahead for DeMontis. This could be a 3-on-2 break, but just offside at the line. Go the ice.
Yeah, they got a little bit tripped up there because of the line change happening for the Hiboux. The defender coming off the ice and just causing just a little bit of a stutter step by DeMontis, causing the ice house to go offside.
That was Gianna Griffith who came off the bench, and I've been really impressed with her play, not only yesterday in the historic all-women's blind hockey game, but here in the open division as well. Griffith has played really solid on that blue line for the Hiboux. She made a number of big block shots yesterday. I've been very impressed with her play. As the Hiboux make the clean pass in the offensive zone, let's see if they can generate a shot attempt. Griffith holds it in at the point. Nice job there by the defender. But on the second effort, the Ice Owls clear it out through the neutral zone. And it's picked up here by Roland Arndt, the longtime Ice Owl. Brings it across the line, makes the pass to Provan. She shoots, big block there as Butterfield got in the way of that one. And with the net dislodged. Actually, check, that was Norman Blais who made that big shot block there for the Hiboux.
Off to a good start here. Both these teams still, you know, 2-1 game, tight game. And we're seeing now that the Ice Owls are starting to find that rhythm we talked about, where it may be something as simple as the line changes. And now these players playing together for the first time and getting to know each other a little bit. But you're seeing already better communication, better passing, and certainly down low, the puck movement by the Ice Owls has been really good.
Wayne St. Denis tracks back defensively, but Chula gets to the loose puck, has it for the Hiboux, tries to make the centering pass for Foxcroft. Shot from the point, gets blocked as it's in the shin pads of Paul Schmold. Loose puck blocked into the corner, and now Juha rims it around the boards. Can they get it past the defender holding the line? They do. It was Butterfield trying to hold the zone, but Foxcroft quickly hammers it back inside Ice Owls territory. Chula, good stretch to take it away from Saint. Chula in the far corner makes the pass back to the point, but that one just out of the reach of a couple of players, including Norman Blais, as he slaps it forward now. Chula receives it, makes the pass. Brian Cowie receives the pass. Shot right on, big save by Cabral, and then immediately whistled down. Not sure why that was stopped, but we will get the break with 5:30 left in the first. Faceoff will come out.
It's coming out of the zone, yeah. Not sure what the rationale for that was.
Craig Fitzpatrick, Marty Dufour having a little laugh there as they line up across from each other in the dot. And now the Hiboux taking possession as it's slapped over to the bench side of the rink. Zylak gets their first for the Hiboux. DeMontis tries to dig it out. Nothing doing yet. Now Demo takes it. He's got Fitzpatrick. Good clean pass. DeMontis shoots. That one just missed. Top shelf blocker side. Demo oh so close to picking up his second.
He's been looking to go top shelf through this entire tournament so far. And a lot of his shots have just been rifled just over the crossbar. A couple last night high off the glass. But you can see he's trying to avoid the pads, right? The blocked corners at the bottom. He's trying to go upstairs where it's tougher for these goaltenders to defend.
Tougher to track the puck, too, when it's in the air. Just doesn't make as much noise, and it's harder to track those high-up shots. But right now, both goaltenders doing a really solid job in net. As that shot from the point by the Hiboux came off the stick of Brandon Joy. Joy gets it again. That time, his shot attempt blocked by Heislip into the near corner. And then Butterfield hammers it around the boards. Actually, check that. That was Mark Bentz there. And the Hiboux pop one in. Is it a clean goal? We haven't gotten the indication. No, I think it was saved by Cabral. And that stays out. A couple of Hiboux did celebrate, but Cabral the wall with another big save.
Yeah, the early celebration there, thinking they had Cabral beat, but the official right there on the spot, able to see where that puck is, and no goal. Cabral shuts the door again.
Getting some great comments on the live chat thread. Keep them coming in. Let us know who you're cheering on, where you're watching from, and we'll get to some shout-outs, including Annette Don McTavish, Blaine Deutscher, and Lori Lang all cheering on teams in this game. As there's a good shot by Foxcroft, but a better save by Cabral. Foxcroft comes up with the loose puck. There's the indicator for a clean pass, but just as quickly, the Ice Owls now have possession. Juhai's got Roland Art streaking into the zone. Drops it back for Provin. Amanda Provin shoots, and she scores! Oh, what a rip! What a goal! The Ice Owls lead it 3-1.
Great play there by the Hiboux, or the Ice Owls, rather. Great pass from the top of the right face-off circle into the slot. And Amanda able just to rip that one top left corner. Able to beat Dave Brown, and it's a 3-1 lead now for the Ice Owls with just over 2 minutes to go in this first period.
And I am not seeing Mario Ross on the bench anywhere for the Hiboux, so I'm thinking that Dave Brown is going to be in goal for this whole game today. And of course, both teams playing two games, they'll be back in action later this afternoon, so I wonder if they're just saving Ross for the nightcap here.
Well, I did see David Ayers in the building yesterday, the e-bug extraordinaire.
Yes.
So maybe he's around. Maybe he's available. Throw a blindfold on him, and we could throw him into goal.
I was just going to say, if he's willing to put a blindfold on, I think we can make that happen.
Ah, that would be fantastic.
We should have got him in net last night for the
celebrity game. Yeah.
Jason Juhai, he wheels and deals, tries the wrap, and he scores! Yee-haw, Juhai! Back-to-back hack tricks in back-to-back games. This guy is unstoppable.
Absolutely. Just wheels, makes his way through two defenders around the back of the net, wraps it around, and even though a Hiboux defender fell into the post there, that puck was in before the net was dislodged, and just like that, another amazing goal here from Juha.
Four unanswered goals now by the Ice Owls after the Hiboux opened up the scoring just a minute and a half into this game. The Ice Owls have bounced back nicely, and here they go on the attack once again. Sean Heislip brings it in, dishes off the return pass to Heislip after Leduc tried to feed it back to him, but a good job by Joe Zylak as he's able to clear the zone. Laba. Nice work there by Nate the Great Tunis as he picks it up. And he works along the near boards now. Makes the pass over to Leduc. Leduc tries to get the shot away. Blocker saved by Dave Brown. Loose puck picked up by Leduc behind the net. He's checked closely by Dustin Butterfield. Nice defensive work by Butterfield. And now the Hiboux have it out through the neutral zone. Dufour makes the pass to Julien Blais, that time stripped off of his stick, and controlled now by the Ice Owls, as playing it into the zone with the pass was Mark Bentz. It was just out of the reach of Leduc, and with the final few seconds ticking off the clock, the first period ends a 4-1 advantage for the Ice Owls over the Hiboux.
Well, it was a slow start for the Ice Owls, and we talked about them sort of shaking up their lines a little bit, maybe just needing that extra little time to get the chemistry going, get things moving. But then again, when Jason Juha is on the ice for that team, I don't think it matters who's playing with him. Everybody else just gets better with him on the ice.
Yeah, I think that's been pretty evident today. It doesn't matter who Coach Paul Cairns puts on his line. Juha has a way of elevating players around him and making everyone around him better. And we're seeing that firsthand. I mean, he's clicking with whoever's on his line. Today it's Provan and, oh geez, I'm blanking now. I think it might have been Heeslip that was on the line there as well. Leduc has gotten some time on that line as well. But
yep,
it's been impressive that you can pretty much put anyone with Juha and you know you're going to get some chemistry.
Well, you saw it on that last goal. The skating ability is just so strong. You know, he just plows through two defenders on the left side inside that left faceoff circle and then weaves his way behind the net around another defender. I mean, he went through three different players on that goal before the wraparound there. So probably one of his nicer goals to this point as far as number of obstacles he encountered on the way to the net. And, I mean, you want to give full credit to the goaltending here at both ends, but, you know, Mario Ross, where are you? Your team might need you. Because Dave Brown right now, I mean, they're just going upstairs on him,
yeah,
right? Everything's a lot's been going upstairs, up top, and they're doing a great job of taking advantage of that slower lateral movement. Juha, DeMontis, those both goals were wraparounds to the lower right side.
Yep. Yeah, and, you know, it's important to remember Brownie is still relatively new to the position. He's only been playing in goal maybe about 3-4 years. So there's still a bit of a learning curve there for him. But, you know, considering that the last time we had a national tournament, he was playing in the low vision and development division, for him to be up in the open division competing the way he is impressive. And, yeah, it's been a tough go for the Hiboux. But with the second period now underway, hopefully Brownie can get him a few big stops and get momentum back in the direction of the Hiboux as they take the puck across center ice. Chula, nice back pass to Foxcroft. Lost his footing, blew a tire, and that will give Juha a chance to break in as he's back with DeMontis and Fitzpatrick. Juha to DeMontis. Great back check by Chula to break up that scoring attempt. Chula dishing it off there as Ryan Cowie tried to feed it back to Anthony Chula. Delayed offside, and Jason Juha opts to backhand it up the ice where Nonon Blay quickly fires it back across center. Fitzpatrick banks it off the boards into the zone. Juha working the near side wing, trying to cut his way to the net, takes it all the way behind the goal, working for a passing option as Arndt comes off the bench. Juha can't make the clean pass yet. Now the pass buzzer. You don't see that too often, but hey, if the refs give it to you, take it.
Mm-hmm.
As Chula trying to take it up the ice, but a long shift there for him, and he'll peel off for a change.
Chula's the guy on this Hiboux team that really needs to drive the engine. He's the guy who's probably their top skater,
yep,
fastest guy. He needs to be the Juha of the Hiboux. He needs to get that going, and we saw that yesterday.
Yeah.
When he was clicking, that team was clicking. So watch for him. I mean, how Chula goes, the Hiboux will probably go.
Yeah, Chula. Oh, big save there by Dave Brown in tight on Amanda Provan. Nice save there by downtown Dave Brown.
That puck was on its side. Didn't seem to really be offering up any big audio cues for him until the last moment. And he just dropped into that butterfly position, covered it up. Great reaction there by Dave Brown.
As he makes a big stop, 2 minutes gone here in the second period of play. It's the Ice Owls in yellow leading 4-1. Over the Hiboux in red as you're tuned in to the 2022 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament. The live stream broadcast, video broadcast brought to you by Parasport TV. The audio broadcast on Championship Sunday and, of course, yesterday as well, brought to you by AMI. as Heaslip brings the puck into the zone, makes the pass to Provin, returns it to Heaslip. He's trying to corral the rolling puck, shoots off a defender's skate in Zylak, and over to the near corner where Julien Blais takes the puck ahead. Blais evades a couple of checks and now brings it into the offensive zone. He's got Dufour with him. Dufour got to clap that stick to give him a cue. He does, and now he has the puck at the far side hash marks. Tries to fire one in front. Zylak backhands it. Big save by Cabral. Second chance, Julien Blais buries it. And Hiboux get one back. Julien Blais, he's got the skills and he's got the goal. It's a 4-2 game.
You get the initial shot here from the left side. Backhand shot. Cabral lets it, he stops it, but lets it just sort of squirt forward into the shallow slot there. And Blais there to pop that one home. And just like that, they've cut the Ice Owls lead in two. 4-2 here with just over 16 and a half minutes left to go.
Yeah, that's what the Hiboux wanted. And now they've got Chula and Foxcroft out there. This is a big combo for them. Did that go in? Cabral, the wall, making a huge save. Are you kidding me? Foxcroft thought he had that one.
Blaine Deutscher.
Yes, I was
reaching
just
out
to get
us.
That.
He says, as a goalie, always cover the bottom. Track that puck. Good goals are not the ones that go through the five hole, but the ones that go top shelf. No doubt about that. Goalie, get out front of your net. Get a foot outside of the net and defend that bottom of the net.
Blaine, we miss you here this weekend, buddy, but hey, that's some great insight. You might have a future career in coaching if you ever opt to go that route.
Well, clearly already an analyst, so good on Blaine. Instant analysis. I love it.
Keep those comments coming. Let us know who you're cheering on, where you're watching from, and we'll get to some more viewer shout-outs as we get an offside there against the Hiboux. 4.5 gone in the period.
Hiboux goal. His first of the tournament, scored by number 79, Julien Blais.
So the face-off just outside the Ice Owls blue line, secured by the Hiboux as they try rifle it in the zone. Brandon Joy had his attempt blocked. Nice work there by Zylak to pick it out of the scrum. Tried the drop pass, but it just got away from Blais as he retrieves it at center ice. Blais, good pass into the zone, tape to Dufour, who returns it to Blais. He's already got one in the period. That shot blocked by Mark Benz. Blais with a wraparound attempt, and Joey the wall Cabral shuts the door on that one. Oh, we have a full day of action here as the open division teams will play two games each. Dufour tries the shot. It's blocked. Blais whacking away for it. Zylak, who's impressed. He's played really strong here today, and he had a solid game yesterday as well. There's a wraparound attempt, but the wall, Cabral, with another big five-hole save. He's really tracking that puck well this weekend. Mark DeMontis picks it up at center ice, dumps it in deep, and he'll peel off for a line change. As Heaslip tries to hold the zone here for the Ice Owls. Heaslip, his pass picked off by Chula. Fitzpatrick, good work there on the forecheck to try hold the zone. Heaslip fires it in front, no one there in yellow, so John T will track over to the far corner and he'll pick up the loose puck, sending it down the ice where Heaslip will retrieve it inside his own zone. Slip hammers it off the boards, down the ice, icing indicated, but immediately waved off. Provin picks up the loose puck in the near corner, couple bodies crashing in front, Norman Blais there defensively as John T sprawls out for a good block shot attempt, and now it's picked up by former tournament MVP Graham Foxcroft. Nice job by Juha to pick his pocket. Juha stick handling. Good defensive work there by T and Blais, Norman Blais, to impede the path, and then the centering pass picked off as Brian Cowie brings it out of the zone. Chula goes cross ice. Foxcroft tries to pick it up, reverses it to the near side, and that'll give Provin a chance to take it for the Ice Owls. Nice work here by Juha as he brings it into the zone. Trying to skate around Normand Blais. Juha cycles behind the net. Centers for Proven, but Trula there immediately, and he clears it down the ice. Wayne St. Denis hammers it off the boards, changes on the fly, bit of a messy change there for both teams, but here goes Juha, makes the pass to the far wing, Hugh Leduc, he should take the shot, he flips it on, oh, and it got whistled down quickly. Juha picked it out and flipped it in, but they're going to say Brownie had it frozen, and a good save there by Dave Brown.
Yeah, Brown did a nice job there at shutting the door, and he did, I think, certainly was got the benefit of the quick whistle there. No doubt about it.
A big shout out to my lovely girlfriend Amanda for delivering breakfast. You're the best, babe.
Hey-o.
Thank you very much. You're the real MVP. And, of course, a big shout out to our Parasport TV crew behind the scenes. So impressed and proud of our crew, Francisco, Paul, Jen. You guys have all done a phenomenal job this weekend. Keep it up. As here goes Juha into the zone. Nice 1-2. Juha in all alone. Oh, what a save! Dave Downtown Brown! Are you kidding me? That might be the save of the tournament right there.
Well, certainly when you're facing Jason Juha one-on-one, I mean, you got to think you're at an immediate disadvantage, but Brown did a fantastic job. Just a fantastic job to shut the door on that.
Juha even did that lift up your back foot to kind of fake the shot a little bit.
He was going high blocker.
Yeah, he was going high blocker,
and Dave did a great job not only of stopping it, but controlling it back down in front of him so he could cover it up immediately.
Yeah, exactly. That was a phenomenal save, but here go the Ice Owls again. Juha makes the pass to Leduc. Nice defensive work there by Brandon Joy as he sweeps it away. And now Marty Dufour will send that down the ice. Dufour into the attacking zone, tries to center it for Zylak. What a back check by Laba as Zylak rolls it towards net. Dufour tries to sweep it in. Cabral gets a piece of it as it looks like Laba has lost his glove on the play. And that's the kind of defensive effort we're getting out there. Forget about Marc-Andre Fleury playing without a glove. How about Edward Laba in a blind hockey game without a glove? Dufour makes the pass over to Trula. Good clean pass. Let's see if the train can wheel. Trula behind the net tries to wrap it out front. Nothing doing as of yet. Dufour in the high slot makes the pass over to Trula. He's at the near side faceoff dot. Cycles his way back towards the point. Trula shielding the puck, dumps it into the near corner. Foxcroft with 9:38 remaining in the second. Picks it up, tries to sweep it out front. His numerical counterpart with the interception. Good work there by Laba, who's had a tough shift. But the Ice Owls able to clear it down the ice, and they'll get some wholesale changes here. So some time for Dustin Butterfield to skate it out. He flips it ahead. Good tape-to-tape pass to find Foxcroft inside the blue line. Foxcroft shielding the puck, opts to leave it there, and that shot attempt from Julien Blais got blocked. And now here goes Sean Heaslip. He can skate, and look at him go. Heaslip over to Fitzpatrick. Shot right on. He shoots. He scores. Craig Fitzpatrick gets the goal. And the Ice Owls restore the 3-goal lead.
It's a nice setup there by Heaslip for Fitzpatrick. But I think the important thing there with Fitzpatrick was he didn't really wait very long to get the puck off his stick, right? He took the pass almost immediately, maybe one stride, and let that rip to the bottom left-hand corner. You're going to see a lot of that, where the quicker you can release it off the pass, usually the quicker or the more advantage you have over the goaltender not being able to react to where you're putting that puck. So we saw that there with Fitzpatrick. Nice goal there and a 5-2 lead now.
And the Ice Owls quickly have the puck back in the offensive zone as Mark DeMontis working behind the goal, but he runs into the defensive effort of Normand Blais, and the Hiboux try clear it to the line. Nice work by Paul Schmold from Edmonton to hold the zone. On the second effort, the Hiboux able to clear it, as here goes Julien Blais. Working the far wing, Blais taking it to the corner, all the way behind the goal to the near side, shielding the puck nicely from any defensive checks. Centers it, but with a scrum in front of the net, and some physical pushing there between Zylak and St. Denis, we get the whistle with the net coming off the pegs.
Well, we talked about that yesterday, right? The deeper you get into this tournament, the more fireworks you might see, a little bit of physicality, guys sort of reacting a little bit, getting hit. We've seen that over the years, right? Like an inadvertent hit. Sometimes it's a little less inadvertent. Guys leaning on somebody up against the boards, and it can lead to some hurt feelings and certainly some quick and short fuses. So we'll see how that goes.
He is Mike Ross, PA announcer for the Toronto Maple Leafs, contributor, host at AMI, and of course a good friend of Canadian Blind Hockey. We're thrilled to have him here again this weekend. My name's Nico Cardarelli, and here go the Ice Owls. Juha shoots. What a save downtown. Dave Brown flashes the leather, and that's two huge saves for Brownie on Juha in this period.
Okay, now you got me wondering if Dave Brown is being made aware of the fact that Juha's on the ice. Because, I'm serious. If I'm a coach, I'm letting him know, because now that's two in a row where Juha's coming in and he makes the save upstairs. Mm. So I don't know. That I'm wondering about that communication with the goalie. Maybe the coaching staff is letting him know, because Juha's, I mean, he's quick. He's quick, and he's been able to put a couple upstairs, and we've watched Dave Brown shut the door. Blocker side and now glove side.
And here goes Juha streaking in again for the Ice Owls. He's got Provin going in front. She rips it just wide of the near post. It was a tight angle, and she just couldn't quite find it on net. But good promising attack there from the Ice Owls.
That was a great pass, too. That's just another one of those delayed sort of passes, right? You think that they're running out of room, but they pull off the fantastic pass to the trailing offensive player.
As the Hiboux now working in the offensive zone, you make that great point about Dave Brown covering the top of the net. One of the things Brownie does, I think, better than most of our goaltenders, maybe Oliver Pye the one exception, is he stays up longer. He doesn't drop as quickly. You can see it here. He likes to stand tall. And that's a little unconventional for shooters like Juha. They're used to the goalie going down early and having the whole top of the net to shoot at. I really like that Brownie delays dropping as much as he can. There's a one-timer from Provin. Good pass again by Juha, but the shot going just wide.
Check those comments. I love the last one there.
Yes.
Talking about the physicality that you can see in this game, and St. Denis or St. Denis being called the Probert of blind hockey.
I'm sure Gary and Wayne had a few Probert-esque battles back in the day. Of course, Gary cheering on his brother this weekend with the Ice Owls as Gary watches from back home. I got a great message last night as well from Simone Richard, and obviously he's missing not being here this weekend, but he's so proud of everyone and saying that he's just cheering everyone on and hopes everyone's having a great time. Simone, we miss you, buddy. We hope you're back here soon. As here go the Ice Owls into the zone. He slipped. Just lost his footing as he tried to make the pass back to Tunis. Everyone's falling. Even the referees are catching edges.
Ice is slippery, Nico. Ice is slippery.
Chula receives the pass. Oh, he rips that one just high and wide. Blocker side. Chula tried to put that one top shelf. Tunis taking it up now for the Ice Owls. Gets it into the zone, but good body work there by Chula as he's able to get the positioning and strips the puck away. Under 4 minutes remaining here in the second period as the Ice Owls in yellow lead the Hiboux in red 5-2. Foxcroft makes the pass to Chula. Shot! What a goal! He shoots! He scores! Anthony Chula! It's 5-3.
That all started at the other end of the ice with Chula finding Foxcroft with a great seam pass up the middle, and then they just transitioned to the offense. And Foxcroft took it into the offensive zone. Chula then taking the pass and just ripping it past Cabral. So that really was a two-man play. It was the ultimate give and go, if you will. And with that, the Hiboux popped their third goal of the game, 5-3, with just over 3 minutes to go.
And that's what the Hiboux need. They need to get Foxcroft and Chula clicking and producing, and that's a big goal for them and their confidence. And we'll see if they can continue to claw back, or do the Ice Owls get the 3-goal lead back as DeMontis tries to center one in front as they've put DeMontis, Fitzpatrick, and Juha back together here with under 3 minutes left in the period. Jason Juha picks it up inside his own zone, starts to wheel out through the neutral zone. Nice move to evade a couple of stick checks. Juha checking his passing options. He had Demo on the far wing, but too many red jerseys in that path. Juha drops it to the line. Laba holds it in for a moment. And then Zylak on the second effort, able to clear it across the line. Nice work there by Julien Blais. He muscles it through the scrum. Blais bringing it in. He's got Cowie heading to the net. Can't make the pass. Blais opts to leave it there for Zylak, who had his pocket picked by Fitzpatrick, who in turn sends it down the ice. Normand Blais picks it up. Hammers it, but Demo there for the interception. At the end of a shift, he just dumps it in and peels off for the change.
I think the big difference here, Nico, is that the Ice Owls have managed to defensively, in their own zone, really sort of compact themselves around the net. They collapse well around their own net. They don't leave a lot of passing lanes open, as opposed to the other end with the Hiboux. I mean, the Ice Owls have been able to pass almost at will in the offensive zone, but defensively, they're playing a really structured game.
A great comment coming in online from Gary St. Denis. The Ice Owls got their wings under them now. Yeah, they are flying, but don't kid yourself. The Owls from Montreal, the Hiboux, are starting to get going as well. Julien Blais takes it behind the net. 1:10 remaining in the second. Blais tries to center in front. Maybe should have gone for the wrap there as Cabral was a little bit off the post. Normand Blais tries to feed in front. Chula gets it. Stripped off his stick by Provin as we're inside the final minute of play in the second period. Griffith at the line. Chula takes it. They're double shifting him here late in the period as he tries to let the shot fly, but it was blocked and then banked out through center ice. 40 seconds remaining. Nice job there by Heeslip to get a stick in on that attempt. The puck pops over to Chula. As Dufour lets the shot fly from the point. Good save by Cabral to get the paddle down. Foxcroft wrestling for it. 30 seconds remaining in the period. Griffith gets to the line to hold the zone. Nice job there against Tunis. But on the second effort, Provin clears it for the Ice Owls. Foxcroft feeds it ahead. That one just went through the legs of Chula. 15 seconds remaining in the period. Dufour tries to drop to Chula, but that was broken up. We have a penalty coming up on the play as Marty Dufour unintentionally ran over his man, but there's the whistle, and we'll get the stoppage with 2.6 left on the clock.
Yeah, I think we're getting a body contact penalty here.
And Marty doesn't even realize it. Actually, they initially started to take Griffith over, but it was the big bone crusher Dufour.
Yeah.
And now they get the right.
I think in this case, it was not just that it was inadvertent. It's that he got the hands up and then the hands out on it, right? So it was it seems less inadvertent when you sort of follow through
with
the extension of the arms.
Yep.
And to be honest with you, didn't really show much remorse. No standing, no apologizing, just skated back to the bench, now into the box for 3 minutes or less.
Well, the clock never got going, and now it sounds the buzzer to end the period. So, hey, what an entertaining game here through two periods of play, and full credit to the Hiboux. They have clawed back and turned this to a 2-goal game.
Yeah, they're back in this one. I'll tell you what, all due respect to the officials. They do a great job here, but I've noticed that with this pair of officials, they're a little slower on the clean pass indicator than we saw last night. And what I'm finding, there's been a couple of instances where the Hiboux have been in the offensive zone, have made, again, what I see as a clean pass, and yet and maybe a second or two after that pass is completed, we're getting the indicator. And they're not able to get that shot away because they're now looking for another pass. They don't hear the indicator. So rather than shoot the puck, they're looking to make another pass. So I don't know if that's something the coaching staff has picked up on, but certainly something that I'm hoping that in the third period they'll pick up on and make that adjustment. Because that'll make a world of difference for the Hiboux.
They've
missed out on about 3 or 4 shots on net so far.
Well, it'll be an adjustment for both teams and for the officials as well. Our two veteran officials, Peter Curtis and Sean Garrett, not working this game this morning.
I think we're saving them for a little bit later in the day. And again, a big shout out to the GTHL for supplying us with the referees. But yeah, it's a bit of a learning curve for the officials the ice too.
And that's the thing, right? The job of the player is very much dependent on the job of the official. So if they're even 1 or 2 seconds slow on that indicator, it can make a huge difference for you on offense, because now you receive that puck. You think, maybe I can shoot it. There's no indicator. You delay. Now you're looking for another pass when you may have had an open shot on net. And I've seen that happen now about 2 or 3 times to the Hiboux in the offensive zone. So we'll see if that continues. I'm going to keep an eye out for that.
Got a few fans in the crowd here this morning. You can expect some more fans to pile into the Mattamy Athletic Center a little bit later today. Again, a full docket of games on the schedule. Let me actually just pull up the full schedule here. So after this one, we still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more games after this one, folks. So we got lots of hockey for you today from the 2022 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament. Started off this morning with the children and youth division game. A couple of standouts there. How about the play of Joseph Robinson in net in that game? Now we'll be covering the afternoon children and youth game with full commentary as we give the youngsters the spotlight. But here we go. Third period of play underway in this open division game between the Ice Owls in yellow and the Hiboux in red. And the Hiboux immediately clamoring to the officials for a penalty call as Blay got dumped, the stick underneath him, but no call. Julien Blay pops back up, digs the puck back out. As the Hiboux are shorthanded here to begin the third, still 2.5 minutes remaining on the 3-minute minor. They're 3-minute penalties because of the run clock scenario. DeMontis tries to bring it into the zone. Nice job there by Foxcroft and Blay as they held them up at the blue line.
Yeah, that penalty that they were calling for, not a penalty. That was an inadvertent contact, completely accidental.
Mark DeMontis stick handling it down low behind the goal. Takes it to the far corner. Working for a passing option. Rips it just past Juha. But now Fitzpatrick picks it up in the near corner. There's the indicator of a good clean pass. Foxcroft clears it to the line but not out. Nice job there by Saint to hold the blue line and keep the Ice Owls in the offensive zone. John T gets caught up behind the net with Fitzpatrick, and then T muscles him into the boards. Things are picking up here with the physical play. As John T and Graham Foxcroft track the puck over to the far corner. Foxcroft plays it back to the near wing. That's a bit of a miscue as the Ice Owls able to hold the zone. 90 seconds still remaining on the power play. Dustin Butterfield battling there against Mark DeMontis. DeMontis sweeps it out front, no one there in yellow to get a stick to it. As Amanda Proven picks it up at the far half wall. Centers for Juha. Jason Juha shoots, and that one just missed on the stick side. Proven centering it with a backhand saucer pass. Juha picks up the rolling puck, tries to get around Butterfield, who ties him up beautifully. Nice defensive work there by Dustin Butterfield. Juha makes the pass over to Proven at the far boards. 50 seconds remaining in the power play. Juha, through the high slot, takes it in tight to the goal. Off the post. Good rip there from Jay as he works it around the far boards. Julien Blay tries to contain him defensively. That's a tall task for any player on the ice against Juha. As he makes the pass over to St. Dennis, tries to get it back to Juha. He's got it. Looking for the room. What a save by downtown Dave Brown. Juha was trying to find the small corner of space, and Brownie got his shoulder there. The one-man show, Jason Juha, continues to wheel around the zone, and finally it's stripped away from him. He had that puck for about 30 consecutive seconds there, and he's got it once again. Toe drag, tries to get the shot away, but stifling defense by the Hiboux. And then eventually Juha puts it in. Yee-haw, Juha! He is exhausted, but man, was he ever rewarded for that effort.
And I'm not hearing the indicator, Nico. There's about 3 or 4 instances there where Juha had the puck on his stick and there was no buzzer. I don't know what's happening right now down to ice level, but I mean, is it just me? Are you hearing it? Because I'm not hearing it.
See, I think they maybe did it early in that sequence, but because of the sustained pressure, I think they probably forgot about it.
I think you're right.
But it wasn't super obvious.
No.
I'll give you that.
Yeah. So, Juha, anyway, he still manages to pot one, and it's a 6-3 lead now for the Ice Owls. 16-20 left here in the third period.
As we're getting great comments in on the live chat thread, keep them coming. Let us know where you're watching, who you're cheering on. We'll get to some more viewer shout-outs throughout the broadcast as the Ice Owls restore the three-goal lead with 16 minutes remaining here in the third. Roland Arndt takes the puck across center ice, makes the pass intended for Heislip. He gains the zone and then crashes hard into the boards. Heislip a little slow to get up. Hopefully he's okay there. He'll head back to the bench as he tries to shake it off. Bit of a tough collision there for Heislip.
Yeah, he's favoring that left leg right now.
Matt Morrow, the executive director and one of the two big powers behind the Blind Hockey Movement, checking in with us up here. Boss, we doing okay?
Fantastic.
It's a great community here of real family spirit and incredible action on the ice here at the 2022 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament as the Hiboux now trailing again by three, but they're digging away and they are pressing. And don't count them out yet. A three-goal lead in blind hockey can be erased oh so quickly. But here go the Ice Owls. Leduc receives the pass from Juha. Tries to flip it back to him. Great defensive work by Brandon Joy, who was on his backside, and he extended the stick to get an interception in. Juha tried to dance his way through about four red jerseys, and the last one swiped it off his stick. Juha gets it again, shoots and scores! Yeehaw, Juha! Man, can he ever thread the needle?
He sure can. In fact, in this one, I thought he might have been passing it back to the point, but instead he just curls back just inside the blue line, back up the middle into the left faceoff dot, and rips it into the open side of the net. And Jason Yeehaw Juha with another goal. 7-3 now for the Ice Owls.
I believe I may have lost count here, but I think that's his fifth of the game. Four or five. Yeah, it's, you know, when he scores the way he does, it's hard to keep track sometimes. We'll rely on Brian Floyd, the great PA announcer, to update us there as Fitzpatrick lets one fly, and that one just went wide on the far side post. John T. defensively coming up with the block for the Boo. Can't clear the zone as Fitzpatrick holds it in. Shot attempt, Tunis. Oh, what a save! Two huge opportunities, and the second one, Dave Brown stonewalls Mark DeMontis in tight.
Of course, we don't really start counting until they get close to 10, because in this building, 10 is the magic number. Daryl Sittler with a NHL record that stands to this day of 10 points in a game scored at Maple Leaf Gardens.
Now, I've got you. You are the one who usually has all the history and all the insight and stories about Leaf legends and incredible stories in Leafland. Do you know the story about Daryl Sittler earlier that day?
Tell me.
So he was at home. He was cutting the lawn. I had the chance to work with Sid a couple years ago. It was a real intimate one-on-one thing, and he was telling me he was cutting the lawn earlier that day. He was doing all sorts of work at the house. He came inside ready to have lunch, and his wife wasn't there. I guess she'd gone out to run some errands, and normally she prepared the same lunch for him on game day. Well, this particular day against the Bruins that night, he didn't have his normal lunch. He said, I had to go to Swiss Chalet. I went to the Dirty Bird and ate a quarter chicken. And I think for about a week after that, he kept eating the quarter chicken dinner because after that 10-point night, how could you not try to replicate the pregame ritual? But yeah, creatures of habit, and sometimes when you're forced out of that routine, it can lead to some extraordinary things.
It's amazing to me that guys like him, guys like Paul Henderson, who had great, great hockey careers, but the one night for Sittler and the one game really,
the one goal
for Paul Henderson that stand out for us, and they end up talking about it for 40, 50 years later, and they don't tire of it. That's the thing that's remarkable to me, that they've had to talk about it in some way, shape, or form every day since. Can you imagine? It's like Groundhog Day for them, and they don't get tired of it. It's just remarkable.
You know, it's funny because it's got to be close to the equivalent of a one-hit wonder. And you talk to bands.
Right.
Sometimes they say it's a blessing or it can be a curse, right? Because like you said, you're talking about the same thing for your whole lifetime.
Yeah.
But you're absolutely right. Sittler and Henderson, they have all the time in the world for hockey fans who love to talk about it. As the Hiboux bank one in. Oh, what a goal. Cabral making a couple of good saves, but Brian Cowie with his second of the game. Chula drawing the assist, and it's 7-4. Nice work there by the Hiboux.
Yeah, the Hiboux pressing on that one. The initial shot from the point stopped. Another shot from inside, just inside the slot. And Akawi there to bang home the rebound off of one save by Cabral. Cabral did everything he could there. But the Ice Owls unable to stop that one. So that three-goal deficit is back here. 7-4 for the Ice Owls. 10:35 left here in the period.
And the Hiboux are just refusing to go away quietly. They are battling hard, and this is great considering the tough loss they had yesterday in their first game. They're showing no quit here in this game. Zylak tries to center for Dufour, but that's broken up, and now it's taken away by Hugh Leduc for the Ice Owls. Sean Heaslip back out there. Good to see that after his scary crash into the boards. And now Dufour takes possession for the Hiboux. Shot from the half wall, blocked by his own man in front, Blay. As Julien Blay was just trying to go to the net, he never knew the shot was coming through. Normand Blay under pressure. Heaslip picks his pocket, makes the pass over to Hugh Leduc. Leduc shoots. Oh, did that skip through? Let's wait for the referee signal. Oh, right on the goal line, Dave Brown. Oh, maybe it is a goal. They've played the...
What are we doing here? What are we seeing?
I still don't know what the call is. It's a goal.
I think they're awarding
it's
a goal. Brown peeked there. He just did the little peek behind. He reached behind. But I wonder if in doing so, he might have dislodged it himself and had that puck cross the line. Either way, they're awarding a goal to the Ice Owls, and that'll make it 8-4.
So Hugh Leduc gets the goal and restores the four-goal lead for the Ice Owls in yellow. And now Jason Juhan, Mark DeMontis working together here for a chance. DeMontis receives the pass, centers in front, good back check by Foxcroft to break it up, and then Dave Brown squeezes it tight to the near post for the stoppage.
You know, we talked about Sittler, we talked about Henderson, both played in this building with the Maple Leafs. But it's one of the great things about this tournament. I mean, there's so many arenas in the city of Toronto where you could put this tournament on. But wonderful that Mattamy Athletic Center here at Ryerson University, they're just great hosts. And such a great historic building in which to hold a tournament like this. And really, if you grew up not just a Leafs fan,
yee-haw, yoo-haw. He fires another one. It's 9-4.
As soon as he touches the puck, you got to stop. You got to stop the story right away, no doubt. Unreal as he fires another one from the slot. Top shelf. Takes the nice feed from behind the net. He's left all alone. I'm gonna say, you know, what Gary Dennis is saying on the feed. You got to triple team Juhan. Like, there's no way around it. At least double team him, but nobody on him in that play.
And here they go again. DeMontis trying an assist on the goal by Juhan. Then he tried the half clapper. That was blocked fearlessly by Griffith. Juhan tries to feed it over to DeMontis. Blocked again as Butterfield there defensively for the Hiboux. As now Juhan cycling around the net, makes the pass back out. DeMontis shoots, that one blocked by Foxcroft. 7:20 to go here in the third period. It's 9-4 for the Ice Owls. As Juhan dumps that one in, and then he'll peel off for a line change.
Yeah, we talk about just the history of this building, and they've done such a great job in the restoration here, and really the renovation in making the Mattamy Athletic Center. So you're not at the old ice level of Maple Leaf Gardens.
Big save by Cabral.
But you do have the iconic roof A lot of the original corridors still stand, which is really neat to witness. And you can go and stand at the old center ice of Maple Leaf Gardens in the Loblaws grocery store downstairs, which is really cool as well. So this is a place where if you might have grown up a hockey fan, you might have grown up a fan of the Maple Leafs, it's a special place to be able to come and play a game, no doubt.
The Ice Owls bring the puck into the zone. Something to elaborate on that thought in a minute here as Proven digs away for it. Nothing doing yet. It's a great point you bring up, Rossi, because I know that just with all the restrictions, especially back in January when there was another outbreak in Ontario and there were questions about whether the event could even go on and if it could, would we be able to host it here at Mattamy? I know there were legitimate discussions and inquiries about hosting it at other venues around the GTA. But in the end, this is the only place that really makes sense for the community. Like you said, not only from a history standpoint with what's gone on in this building over the years of all the incredible hockey games and events that have been played here, but for the visually impaired participants, you cannot beat the ease and convenience. The hotel literally steps away.
Mm-hmm.
The building fully accessible. And as many incredible rinks as there are in Toronto, there's still a lot of older buildings that are not accessible in a lot of ways. So to have it here at a truly accessible venue, it's the perfect setting. And, of course, for anyone that grew up a Maple Leafs fan and was lucky enough to come to games at the old MLG, it's a special building to be sure. As Amanda Proven digs away for the puck in the near corner, a little more than 5 minutes remaining in the third. That shot attempt from Heeslip goes off the outside of the net. Hiboux try rim it around the boards where Zylak gets it to the line but not past Heeslip. Good play there. Leduc trying to feed it over to Proven. Julien Blais there defensively for the Hiboux. Dufour gets it just past Laba at the line and on the second effort he chips it out to center. Brandon Joy, the Newfoundland Islanders product, plays that puck down the ice as Mark Bentz from the Vancouver Eclipse quickly whacks it back out to center. The Hiboux trailing by five. They've really put on a good effort here, but maybe coming up just a little bit short as Chula. He's led the way for the Hiboux offensively. He's got the puck in the offensive zone now. Chula, backhander, that one through the crease, but no one there in red to get a tip on it. Zylak tries to keep it pinned along the far boards as Hugh Leduc comes in for the Ice Owls. Zylak makes the pass over to Chula. He's got Dufour in front. Toe drag. Shot right on. Big blocker save as Cabral the wall with one of his better saves today.
Now, if you, I mentioned that you can actually be at center ice of the old garden if you're in the Loblaws grocery store. I can't.
That was a 200 IQ play.
Oh, my goodness.
Chula.
Gracious.
That was phenomenal. He bodied his man out of the way to get the player coming off the bench, and then he hopped over the bench. Sorry to interrupt.
Phenomenal.
That was awesome.
I was wondering what was going on there. A lot of bodies jumping over the boards. Wasn't sure what was happening there. For years, all that was down there was a red dot on the floor, and I believe it was like next to the ketchup section or something down there. And now there's more of an elaborate presence, this signage and stuff. But if you're in the store, just ask any staff member if the signage is not something that's going to help you, you're visually impaired. Mm. Just ask the staff. They're happy to help anybody who wants to go and stand there where center ice used to be at Maple Leaf Gardens.
It's a pretty special building, a special area of the city.
And not just for the players, right? I mean, for guys like us, too.
Oh,
I mean,
gosh, of course.
I mean, in what I do in my job is great, but until I announced here for this tournament, I was never going to get the opportunity to do any PA announcing at the old Maple Leaf Garden, so that's awesome. And, in fact, this afternoon, one of my Twitter followers, Lindsay Cannell, she wanted to be a PA announcer, never got the shot, and grew up a Leaf fan, and she's going to be coming this afternoon at our 2:30 game and sitting in with Brian and getting the opportunity to try being a PA announcer
at the
old garden. So I was really happy to be able to work with Brian and Matt to make that happen for Lindsay this afternoon. So someone else who not on the ice, but he's going to be in the building. Her sister is visually impaired, so maybe bringing her sister down with her, and she'll get an opportunity to try some public address announcing at the old gardens today.
That's really awesome. Congratulations, Lindsay. We look forward to having you here this afternoon. Heck, we should have got her yesterday for the women's game, but we're happy to have her here today. As Mark DeMontis with a good job to strip the puck away, and he's off to the races here. Needs to make a clean pass. He's got Heislip, and Leduc makes the pass to Leduc, who just caught an edge at the crease and couldn't quite handle it. And the Hiboux are able to clear it out through center ice. 1:10 remaining here in the third period. Zylak, great move, makes the pass to Chula. Shoots! What a save by Cabral! Joey the Wall Cabral! He's got 4 by him, but that was a huge save there with 1 minute remaining in the third. Heislip drops to DeMontis. Nice job to stick handle around the defender. Quick one-timer from Heislip off the post, and they'll blow it down with 49 seconds remaining. Yeah, Rossi, further to your point, it's special for us for sure. I never would have had the chance to do play-by-play at a venue like this, and to be here since 2013 with Canadian Blind Hockey has been special for me. And I think of the times I got to come down to Maple Leaf Gardens as a kid, and I remember lining up outside the exit the night Gretzky was here with the Rangers. I got Mike Richter's autograph. Anytime you came into this building back in the day, there was a vibe, an energy, a special feeling to it. A little bit of grittiness too, though. And it was all the elements combined that made this place so special. And a great job by the city and Ryerson and everyone involved to keep this place going here in its next reiteration.
Well, growing up in Ottawa, I mean, we didn't have an NHL team until the 90s.
Yep.
And so I never made it to a game at Maple Leaf Gardens until 1998.
Wow.
And that was I was working for the Senators at the time, and it was Ottawa's last game at Maple Leaf Gardens.
Wow.
And sat down in the Reds, just across from where we are now, kitty corner to here, sitting in the corner in the Reds. And that was just a phenomenal experience. Got to meet Don Cherry and Ron McLean on the set of Hockey Night in Canada, because I just met Ron earlier that week.
Nice.
At a dinner, at a gala, and he invited us to come and see the set.
Wow.
So yeah, very cool memories of the one and only hockey game I ever saw here, NHL game at Maple Leaf Gardens.
Very special indeed. A very special place in hockey history, in Toronto history, and it continues to make history here.
Well, this game is history.
Well, this game is history as the Ice Owls take it. The final score, 9-4 over the Hiboux. We're going to sign off, but then we are back at it with another open division game. The Ice Dogs taking on the Eclipse up next. But that's it for this open division game. For Mike Ross, for our Parasport TV crew, I'm Nico Cardarelli. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you for the next game here at the 2022 Canadian National Blind Hockey Tournament.